We can and we will. Yeah, that sounds pretty good to me. Hey, we can and we will. Hey, we can and we will. We can and we will. Hi, my name is Nick Barton, and if you don't know who I am, I make YouTube videos on the Toronto Maple Leafs. Today's video is on the recent signings that Kyle Dubas has made throughout free agency. If you do enjoy the video, make sure you leave a like. If you really enjoy it, subscribe. It helps a lot. And I want you to leave a comment down below of what you think Kyle Dubas' grade was in free agency. So put the comment down below, A, B, C, D, F, E, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, whatever you want to put, and let me know. So obviously, I was gone for most of free agency. If you don't know, I went on a trip throughout the Canadian Rockies. If you want to see any of those videos, I'll put a tag or something right up here. Anyways, I was there through free agency, I was there through the draft, and I missed a lot, but I did make a video beforehand on it. But now it's time to rate Kyle Dubas' trades and signings and everything else. So the first signing, Jason Spezza, a one-year, $700,000 league minimum contract. I really don't know what I can say about this trade. It was great for the Leafs, it was great for him. Both sides wanted to come together and make a trade, and this was just needed. The Leafs needed him. Jason Spezza needed the Leafs. They need a Stanley Cup. So what am I going to say? This is an A for Kyle Dubas. This signing had to be done. It was going to be done. We all knew it was going to be done, and it was done, and it was a great deal for both sides. A! Next is Wayne Simmonds, a one-year, $1.5 million contract. Now this, at first, I thought he'd get signed to around $1 million, but after seeing him being signed for $1.5 million, I was like, you know what? It's fine. We have Wayne Simmonds on our hockey team. Now, I'm pretty sure he's likely going to play on the third line, but he can shift up and down the lineup whenever needed be. He can also be on the second power play unit. He's a goal scorer. We've seen it before. And whether or not he has a healthy season this season, if he does, it could be great. Sorry, that A was hard. Anyways, if he has a good season and a healthy one, he could make a difference on this team. And if you put him in some key situations, he could score some pretty big goals. He can be an offensive threat, secondary scoring when needed. Also, he's a heavy player who is tough to play against, and that is what the Toronto Maple Leafs need. Hey! So next is TJ Brody, a four-year, $20 million contract. Obviously, he's going to be playing in the top four, likely alongside Morgan Rielly. And this signing, I don't know what else to say. It's a great signing. Of course, they didn't get Alex Pietrangelo. They got the next best thing. And although he is a left shot, he plays on the right side. We needed it. We got it. And I want to say again, although it is not Alex Pietrangelo, I think Pietrangelo would have been worse for the team. I did want him to be signed, but of course, you look at it after, you look at the contract, you look at all the money that he could have been making with the Leafs, that would have shrunk the cap amount that the Leafs could have been spending on other players, which is good because now with Brody, they had a little bit more money, they had a little bit more chances to get other players. That's what they did. Again, Brody is another player who is tough to play against. He's a big body, he is physical, and that's what the Leafs need, and that's what they got. And now Morgan Rielly can have a partner who he believes in, who he can finally just jump in the rush and have not to worry about anything. This was a great signing by Kyle Dubas. Hey! Now this next signing was a little bit out of left field. I didn't expect it. I don't know whether or not other people expected it, but it was Travis Boyd on a one-year league minimum 700K contract. Now obviously, this is another depth addition. He had 30 points in his last 77 games. He is a centerman, so I'm likely going to see him either sub in and out with the veterans who play at center, or he might not make the lineup because of however many players the Leafs want under the roster. The mystery is who will be in, who will be out during the opening night game. And I don't know. Kyle Dubas probably does. Brendan Pridham probably does. I have no idea. So I don't know whether or not Travis Boyd fits into the lineup. But again, a solid depth addition, can play when needed, and he can score and get some points too, which is good. That's all they need. They need depth. And to win a Stanley Cup, they get depth. They help them win. So what can I say? Depth addition. B. Now let's talk about another signing that was out of left field. It was Zach Bogosian at a one-year, $1 million contract. Now as we know, Zach Bogosian, a recent Stanley Cup champion. As we know, He is now a Toronto Maple Leaf, which makes the defense core a lot more interesting going into the future because there's a lot of players who can make this team. You have Morgan Rielly, who's going to lock. You have TJ Brody. That's a lock. You have Jake Muzzin, a lock. Now, Bogosian, I don't know. You have Lettinen, Sandin. You have Travis Dermott. You have Justin Hull. There's a lot. And I can't picture what the lineup is going to look like on opening night. And I don't know whether or not Bogosian plays every single night. But this guy coming to this team, he's a tough player to play against. He's a big body. He's not afraid to use it. And he's not afraid to fight either, which is good. It's something the Leafs need, something the Leafs got, and now they are more of a physical team. To me, I think he'll likely come in and out of the lineup playing on the third pairing, but I don't know. If the Leafs need key players in key situations and they want Zach Bogosian because he's been playing good, and you put him alongside Jake Muzzin, I don't know what that's going to look like, but that would look like, I'm going to say hell, because that's two tough guys, and they're just ready to obliterate you, and they will obliterate you. So if that comes, it's not really that bad. Couldn't be a lot worse, really. But I don't think we see that, maybe ever. But if we do, we all better watch out, because that's going to come right through our TVs and hit us in the face. I meant to say it was going to be a scary thing, but we needed more reaction. We needed something to come right into the TV. So they're going to come right at the TV, through the TV, into your living room if they become a pairing. Hey! Now the next one isn't a transaction in terms of signing. It's a trade, and that was sending Andreas Johnsson to the New Jersey Devils in exchange for Joey Anderson. Now one quick note I wanted to make out is Anderson's not signed yet, so Kyle Dubas is gonna have to get some time to figure that out. But this, I think, in my opinion, it was a salary cap dump. A lot of people are kind of upset that they didn't get a lot for Johnsson. And to be honest, I don't think he would get a lot in the market because he was injured. He didn't really play a lot. And that came into account. But I think getting rid of his salary and bringing in someone like Joey Anderson, who is a chip on his shoulder. If you haven't read Rachel Dory's thread on Joey Anderson and what he's all about, I'll leave it in the link down below in the description. Go check it out. She talks about him coming into Toronto, having a chip on his shoulder, and him having a lack of development in New Jersey. So when he comes in to Toronto, whether that be on the Leafs, if he makes it, or on the Marlies, this guy will get developed to you know what. And if he can come in and do that and be incredible, then we don't know where he could end up here. She also said he's an incredible PKer. He wins puck battles and he's a great skater. So the question is, where does this guy fit in the lineup if he does make the team? He could be really good. And I've heard he could be as good as Andreas Johnsson possibly in the next few years. So anything is possible here. Kyle Dubas, I thought this was a great trade. I don't think you were going to get much for Andreas Johnsson. And I thought doing this subtle thing to get rid of Johnsson's cap and bring in somebody like that, it just did wonders. Me! The next one was Joey Vesey signing a one-year $900K contract. Now, solid winger coming to this team, looking to make a difference. And he obviously didn't have the best time in Buffalo. So I think he's also going to be coming in with a chip on his shoulder, looking to make a strong impact. And where he plays is still a mystery. He could play the third line with Alexander Kerfoot. I know in the recent stuff that has been talked about, Mike Babcock used to want him to come in and possibly be a winger on Austin Matthews' line. I don't know if that happens either. I don't really see that happening, but you never know. Anything's possible. But if he plays alongside his friend, his former teammate, Alexander Kerfoot, it could happen. I don't know whether or not he slots in there. I don't know whether or not he slots in on the fourth line, but he's likely going to play in one of those two spots. Again, this is another solid depth addition. VC can move up and down the lineup if need be. If there's injuries, he can come in, play a role. Hopefully it could be a key role. We don't know that yet. And last but not least on VC, if he's not doing good and this is not panning out in Toronto, the Leafs can go ahead and do a cap dump. That's one of the good things about having so much money in the organization. They did good on this, getting him to under $1 million, and I think this was a good deal, fair for both sides. And let's hope it works out, because VC would be great on this team. We all know that. Hopefully things work. B! Now the next signing was also out of left field, although I've said in the past that the Leafs need to make this happen. When they did have a goaltending backup issue. They didn't have one. I thought they should have gone for this guy. They didn't. They got Jack Campbell. Now they get him. They get Arundel at a one-year $800K contract. With a career 908 save percentage in the NHL, Arundel likely comes into this team and goes down to play with the Marlies, and if there's any goaltender that's injured, whether that be Anderson or Campbell, he likely comes up and provides backup for one of those two. And one thing I want to mention, I don't want this to happen, don't think it's going to happen, but Jack Campbell is good enough, I think, to be a starter in the NHL. Arundel is good enough to be a backup. They also could go back and forth playing games. That's if they were to trade Frederik Andersen before the trade deadline. Or if they don't re-sign him, they could sign Arundel again and have them two as a tandem of Campbell and Dell. Don't know if that happens. I don't think it does. I'm just saying that could be a route that the Leafs may want to go down in the future. I don't think it's going to happen. The Leafs are not going to trade Frederik Andersen. Why did I even say that? It's not going to happen. It could happen eventually, but we're not going to talk about it. Anyways, the Leafs get a good third string goalie that they need because there was so much mystery in who was going to be a Marlies goaltender because Kaskisu's gone to Nashville. I totally butchered his name. And Joseph Woll is here, but is he good enough to be a starter in the AHL? I don't know. He didn't really have the best season last season, so there was a lot of mystery. But thankfully, they've solved it with bringing in Arundel. The next free agent signing is probably one of my favorite in the history of Leafs signings. 1 year at $700,000 for Joe Thornton. Hall of Famer Jumbo Joe. I don't know what to say other than wow. Wow, wow, wow. We know that Joe Thornton is older. We know that he may not make a big impact like he did in San Jose for some of those years. But this guy is great. He provides a lot of depth. He's great in the dressing room for all the younger guys. And again, he's tough to play against. And that's what this Leafs team needs. Although he's old, although he may not be as fast as he was, he is a good player. The Leafs need good players to win Stanley Cups. Joe Thornton needs a Stanley Cup. Put them two together, you get a masterpiece. Next on the list is Ilya Mikheyev, signing a two-year, $3.29 million contract. We all know he was going to be a Leaf regardless. It was just what price was he going to come in at, how long was he going to be a Leaf for, and how much soup did he eat after signing the contract. Now we know that there was a story that came out after about Kyle Dubas calling back Dan Milstein and Ilya Mikheyev saying, okay, can we go a little bit lower because we need to fit under the cap? And Mikheyev went lower. So that's good. That's what we need in the organization is Ilya Mikheyev and his soup and him going lower to keep the Leafs in check with the cap. I don't know whether he plays alongside John Tavares or Alexander Kerfoot, but Ilya Mikheyev was great. It was unfortunate that he got injured because he was playing really good. And then going into the return to play in the training camp, all the reporters were like, oh my God, Ilya Mikheyev looks so good. And I was like, okay, well, let's see if he shows up. He didn't show up a lot in the series against Columbus, but he was good. And hopefully, with him healed up, with him feeling better, with this new contract, he can play better and he can play as good as he did in the beginning of last season. Hey! Now the last signing that we're going to talk about in probably a ridiculously long video already is Travis Dermott signing a 1 year, let me see if I can do this without reading, $874,125 contract. I said it right. I don't see this contract as a Travis Dermott saying to Kyle Dubas, you know what? I'm going to save you some money here. I'm going to take this short deal. This is Kyle Dubas telling Travis Dermott that if you want to be on this team, you want the big money, you're going to have to prove it because we don't know where you're at. Do you know where you're at? I don't know where he's at. So he comes into this team this year, makes a difference, and plays all the games, does great in the playoffs, and shows that he's worth staying on the Leafs, then he's going to get big money. Big money. But if he doesn't show that, and we continue to ask questions about where he should be and where he should be playing, I don't think the Leafs re-sign him here. Let's hold on a second, though. We need to talk about the missing $875 here, because he didn't get paid $875,000. It was $874,125. Now, ideally, this is likely for cap reasons. I don't know whether or not that's because of opening night or something else, but Brandon Pridham using his magic here, telling him to go a little bit lower, and that helped. And Kyle Dubas got Travis Dermott to a good contract. Travis Dermott wants to prove himself. He likely will prove himself. This was a great signing. And if you've made it to the last player on this list, I want you to put in the comment section down below where you think Travis Dermott will appear in the lineup. First pairing, second pairing, third pairing, 1P, 2P, or 3P. Not plies of toilet paper, pairings of defensemen. So if you do make it this far, put 1P, 2P, or 3P in the comments section down below. Oh, and what do I give his rating? 1 second here. I give that an A! Now, before we cut the video short, I want to go to Twitter. I want to read some of the people's responses, because that's what they deserve, because they've been watching my videos. So, without further ado, here are some people on Twitter and what they had to say about Kyle Dubas and what grade they gave him on this free agency. Aryan says A-, pretty much a perfect offseason, but I mean, there's always room for improvement, LOL. Michael says B+, upgraded the defense, added some veteran leadership, improved the bottom six without breaking the bank, are now a tougher team to play against. All of this works out IRL, then I'm willing to improve the grade. Omar says objectively B+, because he did what he did and gave me Simmons A. Todd Lee Offside says B. Juno says I'm in the B area. Six or at North Dizin says A-, upgrade D, Bogosian over CZ, Brody over Barry, and Lettinen over Hull. Got players that are harder to play against and have a better mindset. Thornton, VC, Simmons, which will rub off on the group. Got better at the goalie position. Having Dell as a third goalie is amazing. And then he goes on to say, Nick, you better put this in the video. I say, or else what? And he says, or else I'm going to find you in person and call you Morgan Riley. And last but not least, Platinum Seat Ghost says, sign Kovalchuk and then we'll talk. Sure, yeah. Let's do that. And then to sum up the rest of the replies, there was A, B, A, B, A plus, B minus, A plus, A minus. There was a lot of A's and B's. I don't think there was a lot of C's. There was one person who tried to put food on me. I don't know what to say about that, but anyways, a lot of people are happy with the way Kyle Dubas went through free agency. I was happy. I think this was a great free agency, and I think this one was one good one that made the team a lot better. So that is going to wrap up this video, I think. If you did enjoy the video, make sure you leave a like. If you did enjoy it, actually, subscribe. It helps a lot. Helps me make more YouTube content for the future. So, again, if you did like it, leave a like and subscribe. And again, comment down below. Give them the rating and give 1P, 2P, or 3P, if you know what I'm talking about. Thank you so much for watching. Go Leafs go, and let me know also what kind of videos you want me to see in the future, because I don't know what to make during quarantine, and the Leafs stuff is going to be just all over the place. So, again, let me know in the comment section down below. Go Leafs go! We'll see you next time.